Hey everybody, Reid Duke here. Welcome to a gameplay video here on ChannelFireball.com. I got a fun one for you today. It is vintage. Not only am I playing vintage, which is one of the most fun formats, but I also have a brew. So I'm trying to utilize my favorite card, one of my favorite cards in the game, which is Natural Order. And my passion for this card has been revitalized by the printing of Atraxa Grand Unifier, which is particularly strong in the Eternal formats, where you can pick up, you know, fast mana and free spells like Force of Will. So this is what I've got for today. It's a homebrew version of Sultai featuring Natural Order for Atraxa, and I'm gonna play it through a 4-round vintage preliminary event. I want to shout out the CFB Pro subscription. So deep dive into Magic with the CFB Pro subscription. It's all part of the TCG Player subscription. So not just CFB Pro, you get free shipping on direct by TCG Player orders. Bonus bucks on your orders, only $7 per month. So take a look and see if that's a good fit for you. Shout out also to Ultimate Guard for being a longtime sponsor of me and my channel and my teammates. Thank you, Ultimate Guard. And thank you all for listening. What do you say we get to it? My hand is perhaps a little unexciting by vintage standards, but I've got mana and a Force of Will, so we'll run with it. Void Mirror. So that would basically turn off my Force of Will. How do I feel about that? I guess I should force it. It's like not that big of a deal, but what am I saving my Force of Will for if I can't cast it on a future spell? Elvish Spirit Guide for Elvish Reclaimer. Okay. I mean, I could strip mine and just hope they never have another land. That doesn't really seem like a good play. I'm going to play Tropical Island and Preordain. I think I'm feeling bottom here. Okay. Not the best showing for my homebrew so far, but Atraxa, you know, it is castable. I have Black Lotus in my deck. I have Deathrite Shamans to make white mana. And then at worst, you can pitch it to Force of Will. Can also, of course, brainstorm it back into the deck if that works out. So what is an Elvish Reclaimer player going to get in Vintage? The lands that are legal in Vintage that are not legal in Legacy would include, like, Library of Alexandria, Bazaar of Baghdad, Talarian Academy. None of those seem really super meaningful here. Okay, I think I'm just going to pass with Assassin's Trophy and see what happens. If they're going to go for the Dark Depths combo, I can really make life difficult on them between Strip Mine and Assassin's Trophy. And then I didn't want to trophy the Reclaimer and then just have them play Dark Depths from their hand and I lose. All right, they played Forest. Hopefully that's their one basic, so they won't even get value out of Assassin's Trophy. Yeah, that's fine. My Natural Order target's gone, but I can still search for, like, you know, Uro or Leovold or something that's reasonably powerful. I can do that if I find a green fetch land to get my Dryad Arbor. But for right now, it's just going to be Strip Mine pass. If they crack this Verdant Catacombs, I can trophy the Reclaimer in response. They won't be able to activate it. Sometimes with Vintage you get fireworks, other times you get slow, scrappy games like this one. You're going to play Sigiri Step to protect your Reclaimer, yep. Okay, there goes the Sigiri Step. What are you going to search for? Your own Strip Mine. All right, let me go ahead and kill this Reclaimer now. You have a third basic forest. Wow, they do have the third basic forest. Props. So I guess I could lose to a Dark Depths here. My thinking is that if they have to Strip Mine my Strip Mine, then I get the clean 2-for-1. But maybe that's not worth leaving myself in trouble against a Dark Depths. We're getting in the realm of just casting this Atraxa. I would need to find Deathrite Shaman or Black Lotus to do it. You're copying Forest. So that works against Wasteland. It does not work against Strip Mine. I think I'm cool with this. Six mana. Chalice for three? That's I didn't know that was a vintage play that you could make Chalice for three. But yep. There you have it. I probably should have done this a while ago, but I'm just gonna strip mine the forest, thespian stage. They only have one card in their hand, so they can't like present the combo based on what they have right now. Oh no, crop rotation. Okay. They have zero cards, so they're looking to just draw Dark Depths out, right? Or I guess another crop rotation, whatever it might be. It's a shame for me that this is my... I think it's exactly... No. It's two Polluted Deltas, two non-green fetch lands in the deck. All right, so now they're playing against... playing around Wasteland there. So I can natural order for Uro, which is probably a fine play. Such a weird game. Yeah, Uro's got to be the best one right here. Oh, although the Chalice for three stops my Uro. Maybe I should have just gotten Tarmogoyf. Unreal. Okay. And then I said that I just needed Black Lotus to cast Atraxa, but that was actually not correct because of the Null Rod. I should have just left the Deathrite Shaman on the battlefield to make white mana and cast Atraxa. What am I doing? The Bojuka Bog, it gets me. It's not that big of a deal because I already... the Chalice was already going to be good against Uro, but I'm just a mess. I have no idea why I made that play. Yeah, if you're watching at home and you're confused, it's for good reason. I should have just left the Deathrite Shaman on the battlefield and just used it for white mana and cast Atraxa. That was the winning play. And now I just have to hope my opponent doesn't draw anything for a bunch of turns. All right, well, that's helpful in case they draw, like, Crop Rotation or Elvish Reclaimer. Oh, well, they found Dark Depths. I have to sort of represent that I have an answer to the combo. Like, I have to represent Assassin's Trophy effectively. If I don't do that, they're just going to go for it and kill me. I mean, they don't kill me in one shot, but I don't think I really have a way to get back into this. Yep. So I need to draw... okay, I guess they Chalice 3 because they're worried about Oko. I need to draw, like, basically a power card. I need to draw Brainstorm, Ancestral, Time Walk, Demonic Tutor. All right. Yeah, that was ugly. Probably should have just cast Atraxa and won that game pretty easily. Force of Vigor, Nature's Claim, Fatal Push, Snuff Out. How do I feel about Mental Misstep in this matchup? does counter crop rotation and Elvish Reclaimer, so I'm sure that's enough. Leovold doesn't seem particularly good. Collector Oof probably actually hurts me more than it hurts the opponent. So what do I want? Like, should have had probably just Leovold instead of Collector Oof. Gonna mulligan. So if no lands wind up in the graveyard, I can't make mana. Then this one's fine. Tropical Island, Preordain. Turn one, Narset. I think I'm on board with that. Or turn two, Oko. But if I don't use the Lotus now, they could easily play a Null Rod. I don't know if they would have kept in Null Rod after sideboarding, but I don't really want to risk it. Once Upon a Time. Okay. Found Dark Depths. Okay, Black Lotus. Just like last game, I feel like I kind of just have to counter the Void Mirror, so otherwise Force of Will goes dead. All right. I have to control a swamp to use Snuff Out. Sure, well, I'll minus two the Narset. Sure. Billy Needle naming Wasteland, you got it. Narset's down. All right. So just straight up colorless land. Opponent has three cards in hand, one is Dark Depths. Ooh. So if they have a Yavimaya, then they go Sacrifice Forest for Yavimaya, then they can combo the following turn. I'm going to search for Bayou, which gives me green mana, and it gives me a swamp for the Snuff Out. Then I'm going to Green Sun for one and grab Deathrite Shaman, which can give me the blue mana for Oko, so that's a plan. Okay, so let's let this resolve. They do have Yavimaya, so they're going for the play that I mentioned. I'm going to Snuff Out the Reclaimer. And then let's hope they just go for it outright, and then the Oko can save me. If they wait until my end step, then I think I'm just going to lose, but they might not make that play because it's bad against Strip Mine, or it's bad against me having an answer to the Pithing Needle in response. So they have a tough choice. It's like, do they want to play around Oko, or do they want to play around Strip Mine and an answer to the Pithing Needle. They also have to think about Assassin's Trophy, right? Because, yeah, I think this is the choice that I would make if I was them. It's going to be incorrect in this particular case, it's not going to be incorrect in this case. It's going to not work out well in this case, but you have to make decisions in the face of uncertainty sometimes. Okay, so let's not get greedy. I'm just going to play the Oko. No. Wow, they've done it. Elvish Spirit Guide and Crop Rotation were the last two cards in their hand. They get the Sajiri step. Wow, just hats off. I mean, you have to give credit where credit's due. It's my fault for just playing really, really badly to lose game one. And this game, I feel okay about the decisions that I made, but I was just beaten fair and square. All right, friends, I'm back. First round is a little ugly, but I'm still searching for my first win with this new brew. I'm okay with this opening hand on the play. So I'll grab my Dryad Arbor, turn two Uro plus Wasteland, actually. So unless they have, you know, the busted turn one Tinker type of draw, I think I'll be in good shape. Vengevine, Squee, Vengevine. But mercifully, it doesn't look like I'm getting attacked. So the Uro into Wasteland plan, that seems like a good one. Usually this deck does not have Force of Will, so I don't think I need to play around that. Do I care about casting Gataxian Probe in case I draw exactly Force of Will? Don't think so.
All right.
Start on spend mana for Gataxian Probe. We have, oh wow, they do have Force of Will. Force of Will, Wasteland, Mental Misstep, Snapback, Serum Powder. Yikes. Okay. Huh. Well, I mean, just make them use... I'm just going to play my cards, make them use the Force of Will. Surely they'll use the Mental Misstep on this. Yep. So now, the Narset's pretty strong if they draw another Bazaar. Alternatively, I can make Uro and force their force, which is probably better. All right, that went well. That's just sometimes when you play a reasonable deck with Wasteland, you just get a win like that, and that's nice. Decks without Wasteland have a really hard time winning game one against Bazaar. So now Tabernacle comes in, the four ley lines come in. I think Snuff Out and Fatal Push are fine. Then my weaker cards are going to be like Mental Misstep, Thoughtseize, Abrupt Decay. Sylvan Library is like, you know, just okay. Days on the Draw. Leovold and Narset actually are okay for the reason I mentioned, and they at least pitched a Force of Will. Dig Through Time's a little slow. So maybe my weakest card here is the Narset. No, the Collector Oof. I almost missed that. That probably hurts me more than it hurts the opponent. Veil of Summer. I mean, a lot. These cards are not, they're not dead cards. Like Sylvan Library or Veil or Dig. Those are definitely fine cards to have in my deck. I just wonder if they're better than anything I currently have lined up. Fatal Push. Can't Fatal Push a Hollow one. You can Fatal Push a Vengevine, sort of. Go with Sylvan Library over Fatal Push. Here goes. My hand is really good. I mean, ley line, strip mine, force of will. Can't ask for better than that. It's a lot of noxious revivals. Wow. Yep. You have a root walla. So I can zenith for deathrite shaman, or I can zenith for a dryad arbor and strip mine. The thing is, the Bazaar of Baghdad against the ley line is just pretty brutal. Like, they're just going to go so low on resources. But I guess with madness cards... Yeah, I think the sensible play is... Mox, Green Sun for Arbor, play Strip Mine, and then hope to just win with Oko. Sure, it makes sense. Yep, just pass with 5 mana and Force of Will available. Not that I'm expecting them to play anything. Okay. I cast Brainstorm. Set back these two lands. I will play Deathrite Shaman. See if that baits a mental misstep. It does not. Evoke Fury. I suppose I'll Force of Will that. Although, I mean, does it even matter? I'm just going to win with Uro. Yeah, it's fine. I'm just going to use Force of Will to back up Uro. Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's a tough way to do it. That was Noxious Revival on my Uro. That is a tough way to do it. So here's triple green, double blue, and my opponent type GG's. They're going to concede to the Uro. All right, I'll be back for round three. I'm on the board. All right, everybody, welcome back for match number three of today's Vintage Preliminary event. Let's see what we can do. Good hand. I think I'm going to go for Tropical Island and Preordain. I wish I could have both of these. It's interesting. It's like I would top if I could have them both right now, but given that I can't, I might choose to bottom. Like, if I'm going to play Collector Oof, the Mox Jet is basically just the same as a Lotus Petal. Deathrite Shaman's a little bit slow to be ramping me. Tempting to take the Jet and then play Underground Sea Jet Narset on turn two, but then I have nothing to pair with my Force of Will. So I think I'm actually going to bottom. But that's an interesting one where I wouldn't fault you for, like, almost any configuration of tops and bottoms that you decided there. It's a ponder and a no shuffle. Are they really thinking about Force of Will? I have no idea what my opponent's playing. Almost every vintage deck plays ponder. The basic island, I guess, is somewhat revealing. Is this like a Jeskai control deck or something? Or an Esper paradoxical outcome? I guess I'm okay with this. So I'm thinking that just playing these cards on back-to-back turns will wind up being more powerful than casting the Force of Will. So I'm going to go Bayou Narset. Yep. Yep, nothing I could do about that. Can't cast the Force of Will. Wow. This is quite the deck my opponent has put together. I think it's going to be really hard for me to win. All right, I figure I get one more draw step to find something really special, like an Ancestral Recall or a Natural Order. But if I draw a brick next turn, it's well and truly over. Yep, take 7. All right, so marginal options. I think Tarmogoyf's gonna be bad. Okay. So choosing 9 from among these up here, I think I like the Flusterstorm, Spellpierce, Thoughtseize, Veil of Summer, Daze. Get some interaction so that my opponent can't just like play a Tinker uncontested. Then I don't know, I kind of like the Natural Order package still. I don't know if it really makes sense to cut Force of Will against an opponent who's not playing Pyroblast, but they do have Lavinia. Just tricky. It's one of those matchups where like every card is good and has a role. Alright, I'll try this for when I'm on the play, and then I'll re-sideboard for game 3 if we get that far. Yep. Probably just going for the turn 1 Oko. Hey, it worked. Okay. Looking solid. At least the Oko will put me in good shape against the initiative plan. It won't necessarily save me if my opponent just plays like land, mox, tinker. Yeah. It's a lot of restricted cards. That's scary. If I had brainstormed before casting Oko, then I would have found Narset, which is like, I think, a more powerful turn one play. There's some subtle reasons to not brainstorm first. One of them being Mindbreak Trap. So I guess I'm going to swap with the Seasoned Dungeoneer and then strip mine the Urza Saga. So first, I will Zenith for a Dryad Arbor. Force of Negation. All right. Scry bottom, bottom. Okay. So I guess I should ponder first because I'm about to explore so I can maybe get a free land. So Flusterstorm on top, then Wasteland, then Oof. Hooray! Alright, I've taken the initiative. I am just gonna not shuffle because I already drew my one basic and I think I guess it's mandatory to shuffle, so I have to shuffle away the Oof. So be it. All right, well, the initiative's pretty stupid, but perhaps Oko is still stupider. All right, Force of Wills better come back in. It's just tough. Every card is useful. Endurance is probably the weakest. Flusterstorm, Spell Pierce, Thoughtseize, Veil, Daze, Sylvan Library, Dig Through Time. I think I'm going to keep the Natural Orders and the Atraxa. My opponent left in Force of Negation, so that means they have at least five of those counters. I feel like the Veil can be fine. Comfortable with the Daze being out. I think all of these cards in the left pile here, they all get weaker when I'm on the draw. Dig Through Time. Maybe Dig Through Time is just too good to cut for the games that go long. Let's do a quick blue card count. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 15, 16, 17. That's a little light. I'm going to try to bring in the Uro just to have one more blue card. Then cutting Goyf, Assassin's Trophy, Force of Vigor. Cut the Assassin's Trophy. All right. Sure. Well, mental misstep. Please work. Yes! All right. Cataxian Probe, paying life. My opponent has Seasoned Dungeoneer, Teferi, Time Raveler, Urza Saga. Notably, this is a green Mox, so they don't currently have mana, the proper mana, to do what they want. I still think it's right for me to just Wasteland the Tundra. And then to play the Mox or to not play the Mox, does it matter? Okay, now I've drawn Underground Sea. So just strip mine on Urza Saga looks pretty good, but what happens if I go Mox Emerald, Underground Sea? If they start making tokens, Mox Emerald, Underground Sea, Goyf is what I mean to say. If they start making tokens, the energy flux becomes powerful. I would have to worry about Teferi coming down to bounce the energy flux. No, not necessarily. Okay, I'm going to decide to go Emerald, Underground Sea, Goyf, and we'll see how that play turns out. Keeping in mind, they are still two colored mana sources away from casting Teferi. Just want to make that point. Okay, they probed me, so now that they know what's up. They know I have the energy flux. They know I have the natural order. Seasoned Dungeoneer, Teferi Time Raveler. So I could take the approach of strip mine in Urza's Saga, Abrupt Decay, the Mox Emerald. I imagine that's the best play I can make. So I'm going to strip mine the Saga on two. I'm going to Abrupt Decay the Mox Emerald. And I'll have a 5-6 Goyf. I think I should have declared the Goyf as an attacker first, and then if they didn't block, then I do all this stuff. Because they might choose to chump now. Especially knowing the energy flux is coming. I could easily still lose this game if they just find an answer to the Goyf. My hand's a little bit too reactive. I'm having trouble pressing my advantage. If I had known I was drawing a snuff out, I kind of wish that I had just fatal pushed the token and then, you know, not allowed my opponent to chump block for a turn. They drew Black Lotus. Okay, I was surprised they didn't search for the Black Lotus. But if they drew it, then that makes sense. So I still don't know much about my opponent's hand. I know they have Seasoned Dungeoneer, Veil of Summer. Pretty miserable draw after the Teferi's already on the battlefield. They didn't even plus the Teferi that turn. I would have attacked player, but now that I've drawn Force of Will, I'm going to attack Teferi to unlock my counter, and then because I have Veil of Summer, I'll always win the counter war. I have removal spells, so they need to have specifically a non-creature threat, I think. Long story short, it feels like I can save Force of Will for Swords to Plowshares, and then I'll win. All right. Rallying back 2-1, I'll be back for the fourth and final match. All right, everybody, welcome back to the fourth and final match of today's Vintage event. I get to go first. How do I feel about this hand? I have no colored mana. I get one redraw with Cataxian Probe. I have Atraxa in my opening hand, which is bad, but I have Force of Will. All things considered, I don't think I can keep a hand where I can't really progress my own game state. This one, sure, I'll grudgingly keep it. Just put the Dryad Arbor on the bottom.
Perfect timing.
I'm going to search for Underground Sea and play the Deathrite Shaman. Yep, that's looks familiar. Actually, doesn't really hurt me that bad given the context of my hand. I mean, it could attack the Narset, so that's annoying. Right, well, good board for Collector Oof, I guess. I eat the Tundra for no particularly good reason, just I guess future delve spells. All right, I will pass with the intent to Abrupt Decay the Lavinia. That looks bad for me. I mean, okay, they're probably gonna get like Tinker, right? So then one thing I can do is I'm gonna let them resolve the tutor. If they just get Ancestral Recall, though, it's so bad for me. If they get Tinker, then I can go. All right, I Assassin's Trophy, your Soul Ring, and your Mox Jet. And then Abrupt Decay your Mox Jet. They can't really search off the trophy because it messes up their tutor. But the thing is, if I was them, I would probably just get Ancestral Recall. Like, if I read had Mental Misstep, I would be Mental Misstepping the Vampiric Tutor. So it just seems so much safer. Although they have the Lavinia, so they might think, like, hey, Tinker's going to resolve. Reid can't use Force of Will. Whatever. I think the only way I win this game is if they went for some expensive artifact-centric spell and I get to strand them with it. Okay, they declined to search. So I let them draw so that they can't do the Flooded Strand response. They could have gotten Dig Through Time too. Am I alive? Wow, maybe they got Tinker. Oof. Yep, they search for Tinker. Okay, they search for Tinker. They force pitching Narset, or sorry, they force the Narset pitching the Tinker. And now we have, I guess, Deathrite Shaman against Lavinia, and let's see who can top deck something first. That almost is a top deck, but I can't cast it yet because of Lavinia. So, just doing this upkeep for, Treasure Cruise, Snapcaster Mage type considerations. All right, is this going to be my first successful natural order? Oh, baby. All right, I like a wasteland. I like a demonic tutor. Mox Jet. Mental Misstep and Uro. Then I'm going to play the Jet. Oh, I can't. Oh, oops. All right. Fair enough. Whew. Man, the Vampiric Tutor turn was, that was just so crucial. If they had gone for Ancestral Recall, I think I was a huge underdog to win. So I guess I should consider this like a Paradoxical Outcome deck. It's similar to my last opponent, except I didn't see the initiative creatures. Fatal Push, of course, is going to be okay because they have Lavinia, but it's probably not one of my stronger cards. Days on the draw is pretty weak. I'm going to cut the Goyf, the Endurance, and the Uro. Let's do a quick blue card count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. That's enough. Oko isn't the best. I could see having one Preordain over the Oko. I also don't know if it's right to be cutting all of this removal, like having no outs, no way to kill Lavinia. Might be a little bit reckless. Say I did like one Abrupt Decay. Try this. Yeah, I like this hand. I think Collector Oof is just super, super strong in matchups like this. I'm okay with that. Yes. Okay, can I go back in time and Mental Misstep that Mana Vault now? All right, well, just... I mean, they've played a land. Hopefully they don't kill me, and then I get the Nature's Claim it. Oh my god, their top card was Time Walk. Are you kidding me? Wow, this took a bad turn. Multiple Lavinias. So, they Ancestral, I can't Mental Misstep though that because of the Lavinia. I mean, this is why these decks are so strong. It's like I can have all the Collector Oofs and Narsets and Leovolds in the world, but if they just play Tinker, if they just put Bolas the Citadel onto the battlefield on turn one on the play, there's very little I can do. I could have Mental Misstepped the Mana Vault in this game. I just don't think it's correct because like my whole game plan is based on the Collector Oof and there's so many other things that I'm going to need to Mental Misstep later on. Cool. Got it. All right. Well, one game that I fought really hard to win, one game where I just was totally buried, and then we'll see what happens in game number three. The main change is that I like Days when I get to go first. Having seen two Lavinias, is one Abrupt Decay enough, or do I want a Fatal Push? I think one Abrupt Decay is enough. I can cut Oko, I can cut the Natural Order package, I can cut Force of Vigor. Force of Vigor notably does lose some value against multiple Lavinias. Maybe I do that, just focus on being a little more proactive. Natural Order, I guess, also loses value against two Lavinias. So I'm going to cut the Natural Order package. It's like Preordain, Uro, and Oko back in. But see, like with a configuration like this, I don't have a whole lot of ways to win the game. I don't have that, you know, that punch to go over the top. Maybe that's okay though. All right, I'm going to try it without the Natural Order package just because it is hard to actually put four lands onto the battlefield against Lavinia, especially when I want to be wastelanding the opponent. Yes, I'm satisfied with this hand.
Yes. Yes.
I think it's just waste land and pass. I can have Abrupt Decay, or I can have Spell Pierce plus Brainstorm. Once again, problematic if they go for Ancestral Recall. I don't think it's a worthwhile gambit to Abrupt Decay the Mock Sapphire. I think I'd much rather hold up Spell Pierce, even though Spell Pierce is kind of bad against Mana Vault. Okay, I'm in trouble. Yeah, I mean, but when I say I'm in trouble, I just lose. Because I don't have an answer to the Bolas of Citadel even next turn. So when they get to untap with that card, there's just no way I can win. Dress down, interesting card. Yawgmoth's Will. Alright. So what, they get to tinker again. They're at four, so the Citadel's like kind of turned off. It's all, you know, ridiculous for me to even talk about ways that I can get back in the game given my board position of just Tropical Island and nothing. It's more worth talking about of like, if I'm going to get another turn. The problem is I can't do much with that turn, even if I do get one. Usually their win condition is they find Monastery Mentor and then they time walk. That's cool too. Okay, that's enough for me. So I'm going to settle for 2-2 with this deck. It's definitely an interesting brew. You know, maybe with some tighter play and a slightly more tuned deck list, I could improve the record. So yeah, if you stay tuned to my content here on the website and maybe my stream at twitch.tv/channelfireball, maybe you'll see some more Natural Order action. But Until then, goodbye from me.